Good morning, Bishop Lynch. Today is Wednesday, September 3rd, 2014. I'm Lauren Pope.
And I'm Paige Slump.
And you're watching this week's edition of
Across Campus.
This is how we roll. Oh, 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 oh. We hanging around, singing down everything on the radio.
Oh, yeah.
The word misspell ironically appeared on the world's most misspelled word list.
Bishop Lynch is a college preparatory school, and we should be able to spell at a higher level. But can we? In May of 2014, Anthony Andrade, Sunder Alcantar, and Alex Spiegel challenged the BL community to a spelling bee.
Alex, do you know how to spell xanthosis?
No, I don't know how to spell xanthosis, Sunder.
Xanthosis is a noun. It's new line when it comes to Greek, otherwise known as yellow. It's often characterized as a skin color found on cancerous tumors.
How do you spell it?
X-A-N-T-H-O-S-I-S.
Well, Anthony, you should join the spelling bee.
Do we even have a spelling bee?
I don't know, but let's make one.
Let's try to see who's the best speller at BL.
Spell the word pharmaceutical.
P-H-A-R-M-I-S-U-D. I-C-A-L.
Can you spell the word pterodactyl?
P-T-E-R-R-A-C-Y-D-L-Y.
Will you please spell the word xylophone?
X-Y-L-O-P-H-O-N-E.
Please spell the word leprechaun.
L-E-P-R-C-A-H-A-U-N.
The Scripps National Spelling Bee was started in 1925, and students between the ages of 8 and 14 years old are welcome to compete. Champions of this contest win $30,000 in cash and their name engraved into the trophy. Past winning words have been Cymotrichus, Lyceum, and Natal.
Could you please spell the word pterodactyl?
Pterodactyl?
Pterodactyl.
T-E-A-R-A-D-O-X-I-L.
Will you please spell baloney?
B-O-L... O N E Y.
Spell the word lasagna, please.
Lasagna. L A Z.
I don't know.
Will you spell the word dachshund?
Dachshund?
Like dachshund.
D O X I N.
Thank you. Jack, will you please spell the word kaleidoscope?
K A L E I D O S C O P.
Will you spell the word pneumonia?
Pneumonia. N. Can I have this word in a sentence, please?
I'm so sick, I have pneumonia.
N. E. U. M. O. N. I. A.
Please spell the word anesthetic.
Is there like a silent Q? A-N-A-E S-T-H-E-T-I-C.
Wow, BL has some great spellers.
Spellers, S-P-E-L-L-E-R-S.
This has been Alex Beagle,
Sender Alcantar,
and Anthony Andrade,
reporting for BL Live.
Ask yourself, how many words could you spell?
Here's a fact for you. Did you know that the numbers 0 to 100 are all spelled without using the letter A?
No way, I never knew that. Thank you for the participants who participated in this news story. Y'all were great.
Oh my gosh, Lauren, there's a spider. I can't do that.
Wait, Paige, why are you scared of spiders?
I have a phobia.
According to helpguide.org, a phobia is an intense fear that in actuality has little or no threat.
What does the BL community fear most?
I'm scared of clowns.
Oh. I'm scared of bugs.
I hate feet.
Well, I'm definitely afraid of the dark.
Real tight spaces.
I'm really scared of horseflies.
I'm afraid of balloons.
It's spiders. I really hate spiders.
Terrible phobia of closing my eyes in the shower.
I'm scared of Chucky the doll.
Why the dark?
Mine is snakes. I can remember
Like 2 months ago, I went to Nick Martinez's house and he has a pet snake. He took it out and I like ran in his bathroom crying.
My phobia is when people stare at me and don't say anything.
Hate bugs. I hate bugs with a passion. I cannot stand them.
I have a fear of clowns. I just think it's kind of creepy how they like paint their face up, and I don't know. I just think they're really weird.
Phobia is probably snakes. I don't want to get bitten by them, and I just don't like them.
I am afraid of very small, confined places. When I was a little girl, my sister and I used to play in the creek, and she liked to go into the sewers, you know, and into the tunnels. And one time I got stuck in there, and she left me for a while.
I'm afraid of cockroaches because they're really gross, and especially the ones that can fly because they really just creep me out.
According to USA Today, there are more than 400 distinct phobias well recognized by physiologists.
If I see a horsefly, I will leave the whole room and I will like not come back into the room until it's gone.
Start sweating a lot, and I start shaking, and whenever people like squeeze the balloon and act like they're gonna pop it, I really just freak out.
I start screaming and I really want to kill it.
But when I close my eyes in the shower, I just feel like someone's gonna attack me.
Very uncomfortable, I start sweating and crying inside and just like yelling at them, why are they staring at me?
Go about my business. Like when I'm mowing the lawn, there are a lot of grasshoppers and stuff pop out of the ground, so I just kind of mow the lawn faster.
I freak out really like a lot.
I just kind of get, my palms get sweaty, I get nervous. I try to be manly about it though.
I don't look at them. I can't look at clowns. I just have to close my eyes. I hate them.
According to ctpost.com, about 10% of people will have some specific phobia over the course of their lives, but a very small percent will seek treatment. Will you ever overcome your phobia?
Probably not, because they bite and scares the crap out of me, including bees as well.
I hope I don't have to, because balloons just really scare me.
No, I don't think so. Never.
I hope so. I actually had a nightmare of them last week, so it hasn't happened yet.
It won't happen.
Never. Pretty much. It was worse when I was younger. Now it's alright.
No.
Probably not. Not at all. No.
Understanding your phobia is the first step to overcoming it. It is also helpful to know that they're not uncommon.
It also helps to know that any phobia is treatable no matter how big it is. This has been Lauren Pope
and Paige Slump
reporting for Across Campus.
I'm so glad I'm not the only one with a phobia.
I know, me too. It's kind of like in the classic movie, The Little Mermaid. He's scared to kiss Ariel.
Definitely one of my favorite classics.
Karina Villarreal, Sydney Solis, and Kim Ring dove into the Fryer community to see what BL's favorite classic movies are.
Perfect.
Me.
Look at you. Miss Ring.
Okay. What are your favorite movies?
Amadeus, but I like a lot of other movies like The Shawshank Redemption and The Green Mile.
Braveheart, Young Frankenstein, Casablanca.
Space Jam, it's the best movie ever.
Dark Knight Rises, Memento, Date Night, Fight Club.
I really like The Longest Yard, pretty much anything with Will Ferrell in it.
The Best Years of Our Lives, I think Superbad is hilarious. What do you think it takes for a movie to be considered a classic?
I think it has to have longevity. Like, it needed to be popular when it came out, and it needs to be just as popular today.
It would have to stand up for the test of time. You also have iconic characters, because people still quote those movies.
It just needs to be really unique in how they portray their story.
One thing that any type of art needs to do to be considered a classic is push the envelope.
I think it has to tell a story in a way that it hasn't been told before.
According to Turner Classic Movies, one of the only channels to be completely dedicated to showing classics, the top 10 movies include Should Ladies Behave, Gone with the Wind, in Casablanca.
What time period would you associate most classic movies to be in?
Probably Gone with the Wind, actually, because it was actually the first movie to be in colors.
Citizen Kane.
Godfather.
The American Film Institute lists Citizen Kane
as the most important film made in the United States. For me, the idea of a classic isn't just whether it stands the test of time. Oftentimes a classic is one just because it was a breakthrough film. It had a groundbreaking moment. It told a story in a way that it had never been told before.
What kind of effects do you think an iconic or a classic movie has on a generation?
Kids try to be like the people in the movies that I know there are like spikes in sales.
Yeah, movies do have an effect on the generation. Like Saturday Night Live, for example, when that came out in the early 70s, all of a sudden people would start using the language, or there are actions of a certain iconic character that would just enter the culture and people would, you know, start acting like that character.
Toto, I have a feeling we're not in Kansas anymore.
According to Rotten Tomatoes' list of top 100 classic movies, The Wizard of Oz is at the top of the list.
How do you come about finding classic movies?
I take Film One right now, so I see a lot of classic films that way.
Usually when I'm watching movies with, you know, my parents or like in film class.
Watching movies with my grandparents.
Your parents, as a child, the classic movies, you just see them and they'll be watching it and then you'll start watching it and then you'll realize it's a really classic movie. You kind of see the culture back then.
What time period would you associate most classic movies to be in?
Probably black and white time, or right when it's switching over from black and white to color.
Maybe 1960 to 1980.
The past.
We continue to evolve. Earlier films paved the way for the things that you see now.
Each decade sort of has its standards. You look at the 30s. In 1939, you had Gone with the Wind and Wizard of Oz, so that's a golden age. Right. The 70s had great De Niro movies.
I really don't think it has to do with the time period. I think it's just more about what the movie's about and what it teaches.
Wow, those are some great movies. If you're ever just feeling down, just go watch a classic.
Thank you for watching this week's edition of Across Campus. We'll see you next week.
Where the news is.
Right where you are.
Across campus.